Here's how to use ChatGPT for Google search. Put in your Google search and you'll see Google and ChatGPT results right next to each other. Once you enable ChatGPT Google, you can have Google GPT running automatically in the background. Or you can set it to use GPT Google only if you add a question mark after the search phrase. ChatGPT Google search works by installing the ChatGPT Google Chrome extension. So let's jump into how to download, enable, and install ChatGPT for Google. First step is to create a ChatGPT account, and if you haven't already, you can do it in just 2 minutes for free. Just go to this website, chat.openai.com, or follow along with the tutorial video above. You can do it from your computer or phone. It's a very standard sign-up process, so go ahead with that. Okay, assuming that you've already got a ChatGPT account, let's go ahead with the next step, and that is to type into Google ChatGPT for Google extension. A few results come up, but this one here is the one that has been verified and is being continually worked on, so it's being kept up to date. And so look out for this logo here. That's the one. Now, if you're unfamiliar with extensions, all it does is add in kind of like a plugin, and they are virus free, so you don't need to worry about that. But you can easily remove them if you don't like it. So we can just scan over what the overview of this extension is. It talks about that ChatGPT puts a response alongside when you put a Google search result in. Here's a few features. Notable is the custom trigger mode, which we'll get to later. Feel free to read more about ChatGPT if you want. So on how to install ChatGPT for Google, this is how we do it. Just click Add to Chrome. Now it's asking if it can add ChatGPT for Google, and it's gonna say, it can read and change your data on a number of websites. So let's show details on that. And you can see that it's going to just do that from all openai.com sites. So it's not going to look at your data from other websites. So let's now click the Add to Chrome extension to download the ChatGPT Google search extension. Okay, so we've got the notification here saying that the extension has been added to Chrome, and you can manage your extensions by clicking the extensions icon here in the window menu. And we can see straight away that if we did want to remove the extension, we can come along to the ChatGPT for Google extension and click remove from Chrome. Coming out of that now, we can see that there's a number of options here for Google ChatGPT. We've got the trigger mode, so you can choose between trigger modes of every time you put a Google search in, it will come up with ChatGPT result, or only when you put a question mark, which could be quite helpful if you don't always want to see ChatGPT result. And then manually, so there'll be a manual button for it to activate. You got your themes of dark mode, light mode, or auto, so we'll leave it with auto. And then this is great here that the language will be recognized automatically and will come up in whatever input language you have. So this is great for non-English speakers. This one here is, if you're familiar with the ChatGPT account, it puts in the sidebar a history of all conversations that you've had with ChatGPT. So because these are just general questions, you might want to enable this button here. Okay, once Google GPT has been installed, next we can just go to Google. So we'll close this one down and go back to our Google search. And now we'll do a search and check how it logs into our ChatGPT account. So interesting, we're doing bubble tea. So how about we how to make bubble tea and see what result we come up. Okay, here's the Google results. So I'm currently logged out of all sessions of ChatGPT, so that is why it is showing this message. But once you're logged in, you're good to go. It will stay logged in. However, yeah, OpenAI requires passing a security check every once in a while to make sure that everything's kosher. So let's go ahead and log into ChatGPT. We'll just skim through this. And now you can see we are logged into ChatGPT. So I can just go ahead and close that now. And we'll come back to the search result and just try it again. And straight away, we can see that ChatGPT, I've already logged it in, and it is now going to give me the ChatGPT response on how to make bubble tea.
You can't get this ChatGPT Google Chrome extension on your phone, but did you know you can install the ChatGPT app shortcut for iPhone and Android? Watch the video above to learn how on iPhone, or for Android, click the thumbnail at the end of this video. So here's our result. Now we can see ChatGPT versus Google. We've got the typical Google results with a couple of pictures, maybe with some websites that have some good search volume, but we can't see the answer straight away. What we can do is sometimes when we click on these drill downs, it goes ahead and gives you the answer in plain text. So that is usually the type of Google result I like to look for. However, I still need to scroll down and tap, and maybe it won't be the most optimum answer. However, with ChatGPT, it displays right where you want it to and gives you the right answer straight away. So the Google ChatGPT has a settings bar right here, and that brings you back to the settings we looked at before. So we'll close that down, and I might even interact with ChatGPT to let it know it did a great job. So I'll give it a thumbs up there. Let's do another ChatGPT versus Google. We can see in this instance that Google has come through with a text result straight away. That's pretty nice. Now, from here, we can see that ChatGPT has also done a straight text result. It's given you ingredients plus instructions. So that's pretty good too. How about if I type in Spanish here? Okay, now it's giving me how to make a latte in Spanish. Google actually failed at that one. So, para hacer un latte en español, sigue estos pasos. Muy bien, we have a direct translation of how to make a coffee in Spanish. Okay, let's try the same thing, but we'll change it to question mark only. So that is now set. And now when I type this in, it's saying I have to trigger ChatGPT by appending a question mark after your query. So that's pretty helpful. I might just this time add in a question mark. And again, we can see that it is working.
Now that you know how to download, enable, and use ChatGPT for Google Chrome extension, watch this video next to learn how to download ChatGPT app shortcut to your Android phone. So click that now and I'll see you there.